What's going on, y'all? It's your boy Mikado Sensei bringing y'all another video. This time it will not be on a healing tool, it'll be on the process of ascension, things people didn't really let me know, but I discovered on my own journey that I feel like you guys should know too. So we're gonna get right into it after this video. You guys stay tuned. So we're back, you know, we're not at the usual spot in nature, you know, at the park. We're at a different park, it's a lot closer, so, you know, we're gonna make it do what it do. But starting off, one of the things that I feel like people didn't really let me know about the ascension process is how deep the changes take place. You know, I feel like those changes take place physically, it takes place mentally, it takes place emotionally, it takes place in every way, you know. But people just think, oh, you're meditating for too long, or you're not really doing anything. They don't really know about the process. They don't know what that really entails. So when you're, say, quiet or just to yourself or things like that, that's a part of the process of kind of recalibrating and figuring out what does work. It's a big change, a huge change. Like, and some of these changes do consist of opening up like new neural pathways in your brain by thinking higher thoughts, or connecting the pathway from the brain to the heart, opening up more DNA strands, because we do have at least now, I believe, 12 strand DNA. Like, but when you start that process, these are physical changes that do also change you on an energetic level as well. So something to keep in mind. Energetically, there's a change as well. You see somebody that's living in their light, that's doing extremely good or helping people, like, it literally will show in their energy field, their aura, like, just pureness. Or I'd even say the physical features as well. Somebody that is stressed out, you will see the stress lines, you see the wrinkles, you see all this stuff that's showing, like, all right, they're probably not living as good as they're supposed to, or, you know, they're going through some shit. But just as you can tell, those certain type of attributes come with that. I feel like you can also see the changes with ascension, during ascension, depending on how far you are or how much work, you know. It's different for everybody, but there's definitely changes, I feel like, on all levels at some point, you know? So that's number one. Number two, I feel like this is very important. People tend to not really understand where this is coming from, but needing solitude or alone time, that's, especially for me, I feel like that was very important, is figuring out how to tell my friends, how to tell my family about this, because they honestly thought it was a joke, but I definitely needed time to recalibrate my thoughts and get that shit together. You know what I'm saying? Like, along the ascension process, you have to figure out what's going on inside of you. You know, certain things may have arise, and like a set of chain reactions. So it's like setting out time. You keep going, you're gonna fall apart eventually, or just ignore it, it's gonna come back up. So taking the time to recalibrate, center yourself, figure out what's going on is so important on the ascension journey, and important for healing yourself. It's like you have to take a pause to see where you're at, get all the information and stuff back, so you can move forward with more information, more awareness, and higher development. You're trying to reach, you know, all the way to the top. Or not, just become better, you know, just be a better human, be a better you, be great. Number three, I think Damon Eccles, I was thinking about this beforehand, like ascension in terms of being a purifying process in my eyes, but he said it best. You don't really gain anything ascending. For real, it is a purification process. If anything, you're remembering. You're bringing yourself back to, you know, the original source, back to your true self. It's most of the times when you're ascending, if not all the time, like, these gifts that you get along the process, these are gifts that you already had, you know, being birthed into this planet. It's not something that came out of left field or something. It's like, you're tapping into that original source, that divine part of yourself. That's, you're purifying yourself to get to God, so to speak. So, you know, inside you really truly know the way. It's just getting to hear those voices, hear those, yourself, your true self telling you which way to go, or your intuition and things like that. So that's number three. And number four, this is something I definitely got from my family, even some friends, like, you're fucking crazy. I'm like, bruh, am I really crazy? Looking at the things that have been hidden from us, and along this journey, I feel like as you ascend, you start to go through a rabbit hole, almost, so to speak, of finding information that has been lost, or information that has been hidden. And when it comes to the light and you're telling people about it, you're telling yourself about it, it seems crazy, but it's really what has happened. Like, for instance, finding out that there are some people on this earth that meditate for hours, and they, you know, even days, weeks, that don't really have to eat. They can they feed off etheric energy, or just any energy, period. Like, Buddhists, I'd say, for the most part, like, that's a true thing, but people don't really know about it, and they think you're crazy for telling people about this. There definitely is deeper, you know, truths, but this is just something that just popped in my head. But it's definitely a deep rabbit hole. I feel like the more you figure out what's going on and what has been done, you seem almost crazy, because you're becoming more aware, versus the people that are not really looking at these things, or just in the matrix and looking at just what's in front of them. There's a lot more going on than what the eyes can see, or a lot more information out there than what they're telling us, especially the damn news, because they be manipulating things to fit their agendas, you know. But the truth is going to come out one way or another, so we're just going to leave it at that. The final thing, I think, is just as important as any of the other, I guess, for ascension, on the journey of spirituality. Spirituality, or the ascension process, should be fun. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's not like you have to be something or be someone, or it's you, your own guru, telling you where to go, how to do things and stuff like that. So with that being said, you should want to have fun on this process, because who doesn't want to, you know? Maybe having fun with what you're learning, trying different things, like maybe you're doing energy work, like experimenting with that, having fun with it, if that's something you find fun. But definitely fun process. As of anything, there will be times where you do have to get serious, or maybe have more discipline, but it should still be fun nonetheless. So these are just five things I decided I wanted to share with you guys about the process of ascending, and things I found out on my journey that can maybe help you. Like, it's a very beautiful process, and, you know, it takes time to get certain places, and it's not something you have to look at someone else and see how they're doing. It's focusing on yourself and figuring out what works best for you and things of that nature. So with that being said, I want to thank you guys for tuning in. We're definitely going to get back on the healing tool reviews in the next 2 weeks, next week. You can check me out on IG to see updates on that, but that's going to be it on this video. I thank you guys for tuning in. We'll be back with another video soon. What the fuck are you doing, bro? Can I zoom in on it? Yep. Look at that motherfucker. I'm just walking, bro. But alright. I'm about to let you off slowly, brother.